Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. I'll try again. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
MashaAllah. Welcome to a Milad Park Mehfil at Haji Talib Saab's house. And thank you very much for invitation from Hafiz Abu Bakr and Hafiz Bilal. May Allah accept their intentions and their efforts. Before any other guftugu, we would like to start the mehfil with the protocol of Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat mehfils with the Talawat al Quran by Hafiz Abu Bakr Saab. Bismillah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بهذا البلد وأنت حل بهذا البلد ووالد وما ولد لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا أيحسب أن لم يره أحد ألم نجعل له عينين ولسانا وشفتين وهديناه النجدين فلقتهم العقبة وما فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة صدق الله
MashaAllah, beautifully recited the Kalam-e Paak of the Quran. MashaAllah, beautiful, beautiful blessing to have a Hafiz in the house, and alhamdulillah, this house has two. Am I right?
Three.
In construction. Four. MashaAllah, beautiful, beautiful, subhanAllah. It's a big blessing. I'm sure you all heard that one Hafiz of Quran, an Amil one, who practices what he learns, will take many, many, many to Jannah with him. There's many hadiths we mentioned, different numbers. I won't go into the numbers, but it's a lot of people. Alhamdulillah, they will be taken with them to Jannah, inshallah. So we should try, if not ourselves, but our children, inshallah. Those who are young, make an intention when you grow up and get married and you have children, to make them Hafiz al-Quran. So inshallah, they will take you to Jannah. These intentions, we need to have positive intentions about the future. Even if we don't live till then, at least our intentions are there, and we will get the sawab for it, inshallah. So we all are here today to celebrate the birth of the best of creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we are here to celebrate, we are here to rejoice. We do not need to prove to anybody why we do this, because we're doing it out of love. When you do something out of love, you don't need any reference to prove your love. You just do it. Like we do, we love our parents, we love our brothers and sisters, we love our spouses, and we love our children. So when we love somebody, we don't need to prove our love to anybody. We just have that love for that person. And for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we need to love the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam more than anybody else, even our parents, inshallah. So alhamdulillah, the method will continue, and I want you all to wake up. I'm saying it now in the start, not in the end, and I don't want to repeat myself. So you know the protocol, say subhanallah as much as you can, because what does subhanallah do? Someone shout out.
Plant a tree.
Plants a tree in Jannah for you. So during the next couple of hours of this mehfil, how many trees can you plant in Jannah for yourself? Thousands, thousands of trees, inshallah. So let's build a forest in Jannah for ourselves. First of all, we have a small Naat Khan, Sufyan, mashallah, make your way forward and recite a Naat. Everyone join me with the Rushrif whilst he comes to the front. Sallallahu alayka ya Sufyan is reciting the Naat with his brothers there. I've heard people say when the youngsters in our community praise the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, our future is bright. But I say that when our children and our elders are still reading that, then the future is bright. SubhanAllah. Because without our elders leading the way, we are lost. And without the youngsters leading the way, our children are lost. So we look up to each other. The children look up to people like us who are sitting here, and then we look up to the elders. So inshallah our future is bright if we continue what we're doing. So going back to rejoicing, we are here to enjoy ourselves, we are here to celebrate. So let's do that, yeah, let's celebrate. I want to see people smiling, yeah, because smiling is a sunnah as well. In Milad method, we should talk about the sunnahs of the Prophet ﷺ as well. Not just come here, I've said it before, not just come, recite naats, enjoy naats, eat food, do dua and go home, which are all halal acts and it's a halal product, yeah? Like a cup of tea. When we have, what do we have in a cup of tea? We have milk, water, sugar and tea bag, yeah? What does it make home? It becomes a cup of tea and it's a halal product, yeah? So is Milad. Tikana, I said before, we don't need to prove ourselves, but I'm just saying it, and I'm not going to say anything else to prove, because we don't need to prove it anymore, because it's all about love. It's all about love. All back to the topic, all about love in a kamar. MashaAllah. So next up, we have another brother called Hamza, who's going to recite a naat. Again, everyone join in, please, and subhanAllah, and whenever you think appropriate, do an ara as well, if you have the jazba for it. Sallallahu alayhi wa
ya Rasulullah wa
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والضحى والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث صدق الله العظيم.
SubhanAllah, MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Beautiful tilawat. We have next Ismail, brother Ismail, also to do tilawat al-Quran, MashaAllah.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَّكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى وَلَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك
فحدث. The Quran is enough of the Prophet from start to finish. Alhamdulillah, Allah Ta'ala put the blessed words on the Prophet's blessed lips and praised the Prophet through the Quran. So when we recite the Quran, we are praising the Prophet, and when we are doing a naat also, we are praising the Prophet. Many people do not know the difference between a hamd and a naat or a mankabat. I've seen it once on the TV where a brother rung in and said we're going to read a naat, and he ended up reading a hamd. And it doesn't look good and it embarrasses you. So the difference between these things, I'm sure many of you will know, but those who do not know, a hamd is one that praises Allah. A naat is one that praises the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. A mankabat is one that praises who? Come on, one of you shout out. Sahaba, Al-Bayt, Awliya, your Shaykh, your Peer, yeah? So a pious person. So remember that if someone says read a naat, or you're down to read a naat, you read a naat. If you're down to read a hamd, you read a hamd. ठीक है, it makes you look bad and also doesn't look good itself overall, ठीक है ना. So bismillah, if you read a hamd, make sure you mention hamd, and if you read another, read another alhamdulillah, because where there's a hamd, there's also a nath, it comes with it, inshallah, yeah, like in the Quran. So next up we have Hafiz Saif, alhamdulillah, make your way forward. Faizan Irfani Saab will also join us, will be taking over the mic very shortly, inshallah. So bismillah, when you're ready.
صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله وسلم عليك يا حبيب الله صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله وسلم عليك يا حبيب الله جمع کے تجھ سے با
Allah, 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 Allah Next up we have Mustafa Nawaz, mashallah. Everyone join in.
Sallallahu alayka ya sallallahu alayka ya rasulallah wa sallam alayka ya habiballah ke gali gali taba ke gali gali taba करे सबके खा क्यों पीके गली गली तबा करे सबके खा क्यों दी को जो अक दे तेरी गली से जाए क्यों सुन ले अला नबी ना सुन ले अला नबी ना सुन ले अला मुहम्मद मन सुन ले अला नबी ना सुन ले अला रुक साथ काफिला कशो गश से हमें उठाए क्यों रुक साथ काफिला कशो गश से हमें उठाए क्यों सोते हैं उनके साए में सोते तेरी गली से जाए क्यों सुन ले अला नबीना सुन ले अला मुहम्मद यादे हुजूर की कसम गफलत ऐश है सितम यादे गफलत ऐश है सितम खूब है कैद वतन में हम कोई हमें चुराए क्यों के दिल को जो अकल दे उदा दिल को जो अकल दे उदा तेरी गली से जा सल्लल्लाहु अलैका या रसूलल्लाह वसल्लम अलैका या हबीबल्लाह अल्लाह अल्लाह अल्लाहु ला इलाहा इल्लाहु पर ये अल्लाह अल्लाह पढ़ते हैं सल्ला अलैका वसल्लम
Next up is Brother Ibrahim. Join it. Come on forward. Bismillah. Everyone join in. Durud Sharif. Sallallahu alayka ya
Rasulullah. Wa sallam alayka ya Habiballah. Sallallahu alayka ya رسول الله وسلم عليك يا حبيب الله بے حد کیے دیتے ہیں بے حد کیے دیتے ہیں اللہ
جل مائے جانا نا
two gurus have been practicing, mashallah. It's good to continue practicing. It just betters your pronunciation, it betters your thought, everything, mashallah. Just to mention, majority of us read Asr before we started the mafil. If any brothers who have joined us still need to read Asr, please walk in the room behind and read your Asr, because your namaz comes before anything else. Alhamdulillah. One thing I'd like to mention about Salah, just mentioned it as well, is that if, including myself, if we are neglecting our Salah and doing other things, whether it's playing snooker, football, watching TV, anything else, even mehfils, anything else, then the rest of it is a waste of time, because your Salah should come first. We try and revolve our Salah around our life, but it should be the other way around. It should be our life around our Salah. Many of us do not realize, and I've spoken to people who are 40, 50 years old, and I ask them this question and they don't know the answer, is how many minutes are there in a day? And if I was to ask you, I'm sure many of you will not put your hand up and know how many minutes there are in a day. Because we don't ponder over it, we don't think how many minutes there are in a day. There's 24 hours in a day, we know, there's 60 minutes in an hour, we know, but we never pulled out our calculators and worked it out. Yeah? If you work out the maths, there's 1440 minutes in a day. It takes only 40 minutes in that day to read your Salah. And 1400 minutes in the day you have to do anything you want. Subhanallah. So that should make us think, you know, if we're not doing that at least 40 minutes a day to do ibadah to Allah, we have 1400 minutes to do whatever we want. 40 minutes out of 1440 minutes is nothing. We should be ashamed of ourselves, including myself, because Salah comes first before anything else. So inshallah, remember that and try and implement that in our lives, inshallah, including myself, like I said first, is to read our Salah 5 times a day, minimum 40 minutes it takes. It can take as long as you want, but the minimum it takes is 40 minutes. Trust me, try it if you don't believe me, inshallah. Next up, we have one of our elders in our community, Chaudhary Bashir Koti, mashallah, who's a beautiful Naath reciter. He's going to recite a Naath, inshallah, with all of us. Ajit Talib Sahib is going to do a duet, mashallah, mashallah, gaijo. Everyone join in. We'll do a nara for them, the Bazaruk in our community. They are our Sar Kataj, alhamdulillah. Those who have parents, take care of them. Fathers, because I lost my father last year, and I know what it's like not to have a father. So if you have a father, if you upset your father, please apologize and try not to upset your parents ever again, inshallah. Ajit Sahib, gaijo. Everyone join with Rushdie. Sallallahu alayka ya
Rasulullah. Ya Sallallahu alayka ya Nabi. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamd o suna halaye मालक आर आर दावा उस नाम उतारण वाला किसे मैदान नारदा लोक मेनू ड्राया
Yeah. जान निकली है उधर मियां साहब कर सकते हैं। मियां साहब हमारा
दाम दाम जान ओ लबाते आए तालब तेरी थी मुड़सा नाई तालब तेरी थी मुड़सा नाई ते जमलक मतलब ओंदा
इतना कदर नहीं मेरा मेरे साहब नू जड़ी अगली शहर में पढ़नी आए हजरत मूसा ने कलीम नमत एक सहाबी सी ते वो कहना सी भाई बनाना मूसा ने कलीम लखी कहना सी भाई मैं नबी पाक ने ज्यारत करनी है अल्लाह के दुआ करे अल्लाह ताला ने क्या भाई जेड़ा ना आपने सामी को के भाई ज्यारत सिर्फ इंसान ही शक्ल में नहीं अवान ही शक्ल में चोसी ते अल्लाह ताला ने उस इंसान की जड़ा ना फिर सापनी शक्ल में बदली दिता उस सप जड़ी ना फिर पालस्ताइन तू मक्का तक जर्नी की थी जब नबी पाक ने इजरत की थी ते ग्यारह गार विच रात विच गजारी उले वो सब आया ते उस दीदार करने से इन मियां साहब जड़े ना इथे मिसाल जते आसे आसे उम्र गुजारी सारी वे आसे आसे उम्र गुजारी सारी खादियां हजार हजारों ते माली बाग नहीं देखन देंदा जब आईयां बहारा
अखन
तिन्ना अखियां दिल मर ते ओ अखियां पर तक
beautiful recitation of Muhammad Mia Bakshi rahmatullah alayhi salam there hundreds of years ago Mia sahab was alive and their kalams are still alive mashallah and they were awliya Allah so they are also still alive in their graves alhamdulillah till the day of qiyamah Mia sahab's kalams are going to be recited and those who understand Sultan Bawa rahmatullah alayhi said those who understand my kalam will become a wali Subhanallah, that's deep, those who understand. Because if you understand these kalams, your spirituality will increase. And when your spirituality increases to that level, you become an awliya, Allah, Subhanallah. So may we read these kalams and try and understand these kalams. And even the nas that we read, we try and understand them and what we are saying. Because if you know what we are saying,